fucking hit me in my face.
She came at me.
Hey, at 6 out of 10, I am,
I did not come to you. Are you serious?
Code 1.
Are you serious?
Go back over towards the vehicle.
Yes, I am.
Really?
You just threw the drink and hit me in the face, and yes, I ain't did nothing wrong.
Okay, let's walk back over towards the vehicle.
That's her vehicle. I'm not even, she came to my house.
And 6 out of 10, it's, some sort of domestic involving 3. I'm with 3.
I got a witness.
Just walk right over. Walk over.
I'm not in the vehicle.
Okay, walk over there. Ma'am, stay right over there. Stay over there. Stay over there.
I'm not.
Ma'am, don't reach inside the vehicle. Do not go inside the vehicle. Stand over there.
I was just turning those keys off. That's it.
My partners are going to come talk to you in just a moment, okay? Stand back there by that, by the cross. Ma'am, ma'am. Stand over there. Okay, I'm just here to find out what's going on. Okay, could you just kind of, here, why don't you hand me those keys? I don't even know what's going on yet.
I'll turn over here.
You walk over here, sir. You can put your hands down.
No.
You don't have any weapons on you or anything, do you? Okay. I'm just going to set these over here.
That's fine. I'm a person. Like I say, I ain't even wrong.
What happened?
She comes to my house.
Okay, who is she?
Her.
Who is she to you?
Her
name
is Tisha.
Is she a friend, girlfriend, family member?
She's a friend that she knows I have a girlfriend.
Okay.
We just went and had a couple drinks at the bar.
Okay.
She was intoxicated at the bar, pounders, you can go ask the people.
Okay.
I said, hey, I'm going home. Please do not come to my house.
Okay.
My girl's there. My son is there. Please just stay away.
Okay.
She doesn't agree. You see, I got shit all over me.
Yeah, okay.
She grabs me. She swings at me. I swing back.
So where were you at when all this was happening? Were you...
First, we started over there.
Over there, what, sir?
At the door.
At the door to the apartment here?
Yes.
Okay.
She comes and rings my buzzer. I got a witness. Call my girl down here. She
okay, no.
You.
I just need you to try and focus. I wasn't here, so...
Okay, so it started over there. Look, we don't really get into it. I'm like, you know,
and
whatever.
6 out of 10, that code 4.
My house. Please do not come to my house. I beg her. Don't come to my house. My girl is there. My son is there. I don't want no problems with you. Blah, 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 blah. You're drunk. You're intoxicated. You need
okay.
to go home. I leave there. Come here. Go home. I'm in my house. About to eat dinner. All of a sudden, she's ringing my doorbell. From the thing.
From the front. So the entrance on the other side.
Exactly.
Over there on Burnett.
Threatening my girlfriend. I come down. She grabs me. Starts trying to swing on me. I swing back. Yes, I did. I'm not going to lie. I'm walking here, coming home. As you see, she is on the wrong side of the street. I come here.
Is that her car?
Yes.
Okay.
She's following me because the other door I couldn't get in, so I was coming this door just to go home. She hits the corner and starts throwing shit at me and everything else.
Okay.
And then
she was inside the vehicle when she was throwing the stuff at you?
She was parked there and had got out. Just like when you saw her, she was outside the vehicle coming at me.
Okay.
When you pulled up, you saw that. I did swing on her, but that was after she swung on me. I did do that. I'm not going to sit here and say I didn't, but it was after she swung on me. I'm in my house, minding my own business. Ain't said nothing to her.
So, but you said you'd been over at Pounders drinking?
Yes, all of us.
The three of you?
Three of us. But I only had one. They was already intoxicated when they got there. So when she started...
So how did you get over here and not them over here?
Because my car's in the garage. I don't park.
Okay, so you drove here back by here by yourself?
Yes.
And they came back in this vehicle?
Yes.
Okay.
And came
to
my house.
So did they, who was driving this vehicle?
Her.
The taller one?
Intoxicated.
Okay.
Yes.
Do you have some identification, driver's license, ID card, or something like that, sir?
Yes.
Okay.
And if you look at your records, I have, I filed she also has been here and vandalized my car maybe about a month and a half ago, and I got a police report.
Okay.
I tried to tell them it was her.
Okay.
And they really couldn't, you know, I tried to do whatever, but I filed a police report because she vandalized my car, too.
All right, sir, if you just hang tight right next by that wall, just stand right there.
And like I said, you call my girl, she's up there now. She's
okay.
She called the house, threatening her.
6 out of 10, the name. Six rubber 10 on data. Last of Frank. Frank Robert Adam Nora King. First of Eric Edward Robert Ida Charles. Middle J for Jeffrey. 01/27/1971.
Yeah. happened. She came over here, was buzzing on his door. I can't get which apartment. Buzzing on the door,
right,
buzzing
it's
on the door.
It's exterior door on the street.
Okay. And he comes out without saying anything, opens the door, punches her in the face. She has no idea why. Didn't say anything. Nah, they weren't in an argument beforehand. They just had come from a bar. She says that she then got in the vehicle to leave, and they saw you, so they pulled it over here.
No, they were already stopped out of their vehicle.
She's pretty intoxicated.
They came over here because girlfriend's friend found out she's not the only girlfriend. There's
right.
Living with another girlfriend here. They're buzzing on the door, let me in, and they talk to you. Around from nowhere, they say they're nowhere. They're yelling at her, well, don't come in here, ruining this household or something. Grabs her by the neck, throws her up against the wall. She goes to push him off her, he clocks her once there. You know, we're getting out of here, we're done. She gets her back into the car, and she says she doesn't know what happened. But she says she knows it was in there when they drove, but doesn't know how it got broken.
So it jumped out of the car and went all over him.
I'm thinking girl probably threw it. I don't think friend.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Friend's sober and reasonable.
The shorter one.
Yeah. Girlfriend's not very reasonable. She says she just wants to get the fuck out of here, wants him to understand that he can't be hitting her. I said, what's your relationship? She goes, well, boyfriend. So
she's saying boyfriend. He's saying female friend, because that's his girlfriend right there.
Okay, she's saying that they have had a dating relationship.
Dating relation in the past. So formally dating?
That is current. I just found out about living girlfriend today.
Why did I drive this way? Ma'am? Yeah?
Hey,
what's that?
It's in my district. I'll take it.
You sure? I mean, I found it.
You're fit, Robert, man. You get the privilege of all that.
You sure?
Yeah.
I offered it up.
If you want it, you can have it.
No.
I'll take it from
ma'am, could I don't know your name, ma'am. Can I speak with you over here? I just want to ask you a couple things. Yeah, if you could, that would be exceptional,
absolutely.
If you would. Thank you.
Absolutely.
So, why did you guys come over here?
We were just actually having dinner with him, maybe 15 minutes ago.
Uh-huh.
Maybe not even 5 minutes away from here. I'm not familiar with this area,
okay.
So, but to me it seemed like we were about 5 minutes away. We just, you know, went out with him, hung out. From all appearances, she thought this was her boyfriend, and she got like a little.
How many times has she gone out with him or dated him or?
Oh my God, for over a year.
Over a year?
Literally over a year.
How would you?
She's a real estate agent.
Okay.
I'm a mortgage broker. I've done mortgage deals.
Ma'am, could you just have her not reach inside?
This. Oh, she's just getting a jacket.
Okay. Does she want to sit down or something? Or
no,
okay.
You know,
so about a year this relationship's been going on for.
Oh my God,
now,
more than a year.
A casual relationship, or would you call it a dating relationship?
It's a dating
like
relationship.
Boyfriend, girlfriend?
No,
okay.
They have been dating for over a year. And
okay.
This guy because I do mortgages. So I've done, and he's a real estate developer. She's a real estate agent. I'm a mortgage person.
Go ahead.
I've done a couple of mortgage deals for some of his clients. So I know him professionally. She knows him professionally. And they started dating. So we all know each other, like, professionally. And they started dating, and, you know, she just recently kind of got some clues that he might have a girl on the side. And so this is where he lives. This is where she's been before to visit him. And out of the blue, all of a sudden, some girl answered the phone. So she got mad, obviously, like anybody else would.
Okay,
girl.
Just a moment. My radio's talking to me.
Oh. I'm like, what?
6 Robert 10 copy. It's not going to be him. I've got a hard ID. Okay, so...
So basically,
how did
you know,
the vehicle get over here?
So her and I pulled up right here.
Okay.
We were right here. We went to the door. There's the buzz-in thing.
Right,
call people.
Right, okay.
It's like right up there. So her and I went up there to you know, because we told him, hey, we're coming over after we leave here. We are paying out our bill. And he left like maybe 5 or 10 minutes before we did. And she knows where he lives. She's been here before. I personally haven't, but we came and she went to ring the doorbell and some girl answered the door. And we were like, okay, what's going on? So she obviously got mad. I could care less, but she got mad. And her and the girl kind of got into a verbal altercation on the phone. And the girl was like, you know, this is
did the girl ever come down to the door?
She never came down.
Okay.
I don't even know what she looks like.
Okay.
And out of the blue, this dude shows up and starts choking her. And was like,
starts choking her outside the door?
Outside the door.
How would you say what he's choking her? Like arms, hands around? What was he doing?
He had her up against the wall, choking her to the
both hands, single hand?
I would say he was probably had one hand like this and the other one like that.
Okay. Okay.
And I got scared.
Okay.
I started walking towards the car and I was like, Eric, oh my God, what is going on? Like, this
mm-hmm.
is not that serious. We will leave. We will leave. It's not that serious. But obviously she loves you. Obviously,
okay.
you know, you lied to her because
okay.
you didn't tell her that you lived with anybody. So obviously she's pissed. And I don't know. I mean, and then he just started.
Ma'am, if you just wait right over there, and I'm just talking to her alone, okay? I understand.
I'm
we'll be with you.
I'm just telling him what happened, girl.
Okay.
Can you tell my wife
that started? No, he.
Like,
it's obvious, girl. It's presses
yeah, like,
are getting.
Okay. We're trying to figure out everything that happened.
So
happens over there.
She barely pushed him off of her because
okay.
he was choking her. He came out of nowhere. I didn't even.
Hey, can you all walk around? Yeah. Thanks.
I was actually standing back looking at the whole thing and I
yeah go ahead
and
if you got a cross
even,
yeah
I didn't even see where he came from. I really don't, but obviously he came up from here.
Okay.
So he must have come out of the front of the building and come around, but I didn't. He showed up out of nowhere and just started choking her.
And the front.
Like,
okay. How did they get from here to here? Because when
so
I came up, the vehicle. You guys were already out of the vehicle, and the vehicle's right there.
That I oh, cause when she made a right here, he was standing right here, and he was like, "You can't make a right here; it's a one way." And she was like, "Oh, shit," you know, cause she was she doesn't. She's not familiar. She lives in Kent. I live in Kirkland.
Right.
We're not.
She wasn't driving. Was she driving?
Yeah, but we were making a right here,
okay.
but we didn't realize that it was a. You know, we thought we were just gonna go back on the freeway and go that way, and so
okay.
we didn't realize that this was actually a one way.
Okay.
And so he was actually.
How did her nose get bloody?
He punched her in the face.
So he punched her.
Oh my God, he.
When did that happen? Where did
that?
That
was over there.
Okay.
I mean, like after he
okay.
choked her, she kind of finally got
okay.
him off.
Would you be willing to give a written statement about what you
oh,
saw?
Oh, totally.
And okay.
Oh my God, totally.
Okay. All right, just wait over here and. Ma'am. Would you be willing to give a written statement about what happened?
Absolutely.
Okay, all right. If the two of you just want to wait over here, just ask that you don't jump inside your vehicles. If you want to get in your vehicle, that's fine.
No, it's
just,
fine.
Just ask one of us first.
No,
okay, all right, thank you. Say again?
What does friend say?
Oh, friend says it started down there.
Yeah.
He pushes her up against the wall, arm against her. Down there, he punches her. They're coming down here. They're getting ready to leave. He sees them turn right. He says, don't turn. You can't turn right. You can't turn right here. And that's about the time I come up. I pull up. And so the punch bloody nose happened down there. He initially told me that the he punched her because she threw the glass at him and hit him with the glass.
That's what he initially said?
Yeah.
Well, no, he told me he punched her back there because she punched him.
Oh, yeah, he didn't say anything about that.
She was buzzing like crazy. Came down. What the fuck you guys want? What you want? What you want? She swings, hits him, but doesn't do anything. He says, I fired back, hit her one time, and then I tried walking away. And I was walking up here, coming over this way. They pulled over here, and she threw a drink at me. That's what he told me this time.
That's a little bit more accurate to what she's saying.
Okay. But he says he never pushed her up against the wall or anything like that.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And he says that their coworkers, they've gone to have drinks as friends. That's it.
Friends
as
saying they've been dating for a year.
Okay. Of course, he's not going to admit to that, but we've got
his
friends saying
down
that.
Here.
Okay, I'm going to need a statement from her. What? No.
Say again.
I said I could take real girlfriend away if you want to talk to him candidly.
I mean, I don't think it'd change anything. Yeah. I mean, she's actually bleeding from her nose, and I mean, they're both intoxicated one more than the other.
Go ahead.
You notice he's not saying anything.
Huh, that's funny.
Which one is that?
Victim.
Yeah.
I can take it out. Check my paper.
You're subject to clear no record. Copy. Can you confirm that valid something?
Ah. Yeah, we could. I didn't call. We call front counter, see if there's any locals.
Okay. Yeah, but is that gonna? If there's confirmation of that, is it, and she's listed as a suspect, is that gonna confirm not a dating relationship?
Well, legitimize this side of the story a little bit.
Yeah.
I mean, when I came up, the vehicle was there. They were out of the vehicle. He was trying to walk away, and they were going after him. I don't know if that was all because of just the punch.
See, well, and that's right. If I got punched by a chick, I got to say, I might swing back if I thought the assault was going to continue.
Right.
And maybe he got a better click than she did.
Right. Well, based on him not being drunk and her being drunk.
He tries walking away, but she's chasing down. I think that would push it over. Personally.
Yeah.
It's just proven.
Right. Well, the big thing is there a DV relationship?
Yeah, how do we establish a DV relationship when two people are saying two different things? One says yes and one says no. Do you err on the side of...
And girlfriend is saying no, that they're not involved. She's saying that you have two people saying that they are, and you have two people saying they aren't, right? His girlfriend?
Oh, yes. Right. Correct.
And,
and supposedly she's been warning him, get the fuck away from her.
Right.
And I think part of it, too, is this is live-in girlfriend. They both live here. She may have been girlfriend on the side. And they just now came together. So it could be a DV with all three. I mean they're both in. He's got two DV relationships going at the same time, or two domestic relationships at the same time.
Well, technically, I mean, if he had an ex-girlfriend, I mean, he's still...
Right.
He never was a dating or romantic. They had some drinks together because they worked together.
Yeah, I mean, if they've just gone on out dates, well, I mean, not dates,
dating,
but they have a dating relationship.
And I asked, was it just going and getting drinks, or was it, you know, hey, I want to get to know you, let's go get some drinks, let's get to know each other, and now he's just friends, coworkers, having drinks.
Well, she's the other side of this, I guess, right? She's going on a no-bill DV warrant.
And that would take
so
care of that.
She's gone for the night.
Write it up.
Separates the two.
Which is the spirit of the law, right?
Yeah.
So yeah.
And you're unable to confirm, deny the DV relationship.
Okay. I'm going to snap a couple photos.
Yeah.
For the night, I think.
I mean, I think we're meeting the intent of the of
the
act.
Of the, yeah, of the law of marriage.
Yeah, that's good. I never had one where there's been question of
disagreement of the relationship,
and there's obviously one side of it is self-preservation,
right?
On two separate levels.
Right. Then you have the other side that she's a DV suspect in another call,
which
kind of
supports.
Well, she knows DV law.
Yeah.
Supports
what the acts were here, and kind of supports his case. So yeah, no, I think that's probably the best.
I think they're separated for that, for sure.
Meg's around the corner with girlfriend, or?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm just going to call front counter. Yes. Yeah, we're kind of coming up to a... since we can't clearly establish a DV relationship, but she's got the DV warrant, we can meet the intent of the act by her having the DV warrant being arrested, the two of them being separated, and then writing it up, referring it on him, since we can't clearly establish.
Real girlfriend, who's actually fiance, has text messages from her apologizing for the damage.
Oh, okay.
Paid for it, et cetera.
So is this kind of like a...
She's like,
attraction.
She's like, yeah, we need to start calling the police because we're going to end up with a rabbit in the closet.
Okay. I'm thinking he's got a legitimate girlfriend and maybe girlfriend on the side, and it just came to a blow up right here, now. So.
It's getting a little extra.
Exactly. And it's nothing he would call a girlfriend. Okay. But she sure does.
Okay.
What's the front counters? 7541. Yeah.
I haven't got coffee yet.
Smart man. Hey, Craig Johnson here. Can I get a local records check on a name, please? Last of Frank, F-R-A-N-K. First of Eric. E-R-I-C, yes. And its date of birth is 1/27/71. No Eric Frank. How about an address? Oh, okay. Okay, yeah, yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, his first name's Eric, middle name's Frank. Yes. Okay. Yes. Yeah, this is DOL address. What are our contacts with him? Okay. 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 Okay, where was the address of occurrence on that? The address where that case occurred, where he was a victim. Okay, and was there a suspect listed? Boursa. Borsha. Okay. Tisha Borsha. Okay, great. Thank you very much. Bye. Yeah, there was a call back. She's Tisha, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a call back. There was a case in May. He's a victim of Malmish. She's a suspect of Malmish. So I don't know if it's, if there's anything in the narrative about.
Who took the report?
I didn't get the specifics of it. It was 232 Burnett. It was here, though, so.
Michael Kimmer, 2607 Northeast 5 Place, 24
violation of DV order.
Oh, is that the same one they've been violating for?
Michael Kimmer tries to get into the girlfriend's place, to their ex-girlfriend. That she's the one that was stabbed? I think she was the one that was stabbed. They stabbed a couple years ago.
Mm-hmm. So why?
Sorry, information.
Number two is green.
Yes. Well.
Is that
no.
Number two green?
No, I redid mine.
Oh, you changed the color?
No, when he went out, I logged on as primary.
I wonder if just that.
Could be maybe it's just this unit.
That unit's green, or. It is. It matches better.
Yeah, true.
All right, sir. Appreciate your cooperation. We're just checking some more things out. Everything that you told me about things that happened in the past, I checked with our records, and that's what's happened. So just relax. We should be finishing up here shortly.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I mean, you can tell she was lying because she said she pulled over when she saw you. And
right.
That's not the truth.
Yeah, no.
I'm leaving because I trust her, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just need to get, I'm gone. I'm home. I'm done.
Okay.
And they still follow me, you know what I'm saying? They antagonize me the whole way.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay. I'll back with you in just a second, sir.
I mean, you were given this first.
Right, the warrant one.
Yeah,
he was saying that she crashed his car within the last couple months, and that was the case, so.
I'm going to bail.
Yeah, no, I think we've got enough here.
Okay.
Ma'am? You're Eric's fiance?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Did somebody buzz the door earlier tonight?
He
okay.
Did. Like three times.
Okay. What? Was she saying anything or?
My man. I want to talk to my man, and I'm like, stop calling our house. I've told you that before. Like
okay.
I told her this.
Okay.
Like 2 weeks ago.
Okay.
Like this is what she does all the
okay.
time.
So how long has she been doing this?
Oh God. Really long time.
Okay. How long have you known Eric?
We've been engaged for 2 years.
2 years. Okay. Okay.
We've been together for years.
And how long is he, or I'm sorry, how long has she been sparring the two of you?
She's only employed by him, I think, like summer of last year.
Okay.
We hired her.
So
okay.
She's an employee or a coworker?
He's an employee.
Okay.
With our property, his property, basically.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Because he's friends with her husband, or their associate.
Okay.
So the husband was like, my wife is in real estate, blah, 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 blah. And she is really good at what she does.
So her husband, the taller of the two ladies over there's husband?
Tisha's husband.
Okay, so.
Referred her to Hank Gary.
Okay.
Long story short, I think it's starting to get out of control. I want to say, I don't know, like a fall of last year, maybe?
Mm-hmm.
It's been a while.
Okay.
But, like, she buzzed the house 3 times she called the house. She sends emails, text messages, she'll call all night, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock.
Okay, and is she still employed?
I think she's closing up. Well, you know when you're a real estate agent, you're
not really employed. You're just
right.
Kind of contract, kind of.
Right.
Type thing. Okay.
So I know they have closing business that he's finishing, and because she's the agent, you kind of just let him finish it out, type thing.
Uh huh.
So I know there's closing business that they're closing up, but she's never gonna go away.
Okay.
I mean, even after the third time,
yeah.
When she finally called the police.
What I would recommend, an option available to you and available to Eric, is what they call an anti-harassment restraining order.
Okay.
And
I'll do it right now.
Well, I can't. You can't do it right now. You got to go to a judge. The judge has to put it in place. And what it is, it's a civil order that restricts her ability to come near you, near your home, near your place of business, whatever the judge or the courts feel is appropriate to limit her. You know, it's commonly called a restraining order. A no-contact order are the domestic violence ones.
Okay.
But in a situation like this, an anti-harassment restraining order might be more appropriate.
Okay.
And what you do is you just fill out some paperwork, pay some filing fees, go in front of a judge,
okay.
Plead your case, and then the judge determines whether or not they'll be put into effect.
Okay.
That way she bothers you, harasses you, comes close to you.
Immediately.
You can call the police, and then she's in violation of that anti-harassment order.
She was just in our garage last Thursday.
Yeah. And in a situation like that is probably the best thing for you to do.
Okay.
Is an option available to you?
No, absolutely. I mean, we have a child upstairs.
Right,
so it's
right.
It's kind of, this is ridiculous. Like,
right.
How do you explain to your child? Like, it's embarrassing.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Okay.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you, ma'am.
All right, my friend, I'm going to grab Chris.
Okay, cool. Thank you for swinging by. As in friends,
right, no, right.
But I don't think necessarily that it was to the point of a romantic dating relationship.
So then in that case, would be good if not doing it on one of those.
Okay. Yeah, I think if anything, maybe an assault on him. Assault 4, not assault 4. What would
him being the victim or the suspect?
What are you thinking?
God, I can't tell. The only thing is I've got a friend of hers, and he's hurt. The only thing I got.
Yeah.
Somewhat lean on one side or the other.
Yeah. Maybe I'm just going on the side that I saw her nose bleeding.
But you also saw her chasing him down.
Chasing down after him. Yeah.
To me, that becomes primary aggressor.
Yeah, because she's not breaking him. He's trying to break contact. He's trying to remove himself from the situation. So, yeah, that goes with that, too.
I think I'm just going to write it up. Let the prosecutor decide. Take her on a warrant.
Yeah.
Like Jeff said, and then we were separated.
Yeah, and I told his fiance that they probably want to get an anti-harassment restraining order against her.
Okay. Okay.
If this is truly one of the fatal attraction type deals.
They're working on statements. I'm going to see if they want to give written statements.
Yeah.
Especially from her for the relationship.
Yeah, and that she actually was on the receiving end when she was buzzing, talking over the front door thing.
Okay.
So. Hey, sir. I'm going to hand you your driver's license before I forget.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hello?
They were just the keys that you were holding, sir.
Yes.
I just want to make sure if I didn't drive away with those. So I was having a numbers dilemma there when I was going, I'm code, am I 3-2 or 1? Am I 2? I don't think I'm 2. What's the number I'm
one
looking
and a
for?
Half.
Yeah, I'll go with a 1.
You could hear him yapping in the background, too. And you're like, I'm code. Yeah, 1.
On the friend? I'll go ask her, see if she's had a ID in another state. Ma'am, have you had an identification in another state or a driver's license in another state?
I mean, in Georgia, like 10 years ago.
So in Georgia, because we're not finding anything in Washington State. You have a current Washington...
For me?
Yeah. Do you have your driver's license?
Yeah.
Can I take... Oh, great.
I have an ID card.
Oh,
yeah.
ID card will work good, too. Careful. What's that, ma'am? I'm sorry.
I didn't put a bunch of information.
You want to put as much information to...
Well,
because
he hit me in the face and in the eye for no reason.
Okay. I mean, because I wasn't there, none of us were here, none of us saw it, so the more information you can put, the more it is better. Okay, thank you, ma'am. Want to try that? Is that what she said, Rachel Smith?
4,500?
What's that?
This is a 4,500? The assault, 4.
0045, yeah.
0045, that's it.
Crickets.
He was driving, right?
The larger one was driving.
The larger one was driving.
Yeah.
He's so weak.
Oh, yeah. Ma'am, here's your identification back.
Huh?
I'm just going to set your identification on top of your wallet.
Oh, okay, cool. Were you able to find me?
Yeah, it was. We're there. We're good.
Oh, okay.
You're good. It actually will hopefully it works for this one. As I was pulling up what I saw to just remember it.
We can't
contact at 7 and 4.
Oh.
I gotta fill out that form.
Okay.
Hey, Craig here. Somebody had a question or someone told me to call the jail. So we got an RJC that needs to be picked up by midnight? Okay. Oh, yeah. We got five South End cars clear, so we can send any of them. Oh. Yeah. No, here, I'll call someone and admin and get them going your way. Thanks. Bye. Robert 10-212 on admin.
I'm trying to leave the residence. No gun action.
Six Robert 10-312 on admin. Yeah. Wait, slows down. They still talking on primary? Robert 10, 3 over 12 on admin. Hey, 6 Robert 10 here. We've got a pickup at RJC that we need to do later than midnight. Can you just go ahead and create a transport and put 12 on it and send them to it? I've been trying to call them on admin. I've been sending them MDC messages and haven't got anything. Thank you. Bye. I would say no. If she's willing to allow us to move it to part to a...
I don't like doing that because if they say we dropped the tranny crossing the street...
How about
it's our fault.
We can probably allow her to move it to Chase Bank, parking lot of Chase Bank. That's within reason.
Okay, yeah.
Under our observation, so.
Here's a question. Did either of them ever tell you to stop this crap out?
Said he was pushing up against the wall.
Now I've got both of them saying that she was being choked with both hands for probably 3 or 4 seconds to the point where she couldn't breathe. Her throat still hurts. She has no petechia.
Yeah, friend said,
no loss of
hand on arm, hand on chest, pushed up against the wall.
Okay. Now, and there's a... I'll be be with you in 1 second. That he was choking her.
We're now getting the third version of what happened.
So I'm wondering if you want me to stay on our original decision and write it up, because the stories keep changing, or...
No, I think the last thing we talked with the Valley Com, write it and refer it.
Go with where we were going already.
Yeah,
okay.
No, I mean, it's we're getting so many different accounts. There's only one consistency, and it's been in this side over here. Yeah, well, she's got a warrant, so no avoiding that. Nobody told me. I was up talking with Brad. He said there was a... Never mind. Two Peninsula people? I have no idea. I'm just gonna... It'll be back tomorrow. I know she had surgery on her hand. I don't know if that was before or after. And she's been on a couple different narcotics, and she's apparently doesn't handle them very well. So I don't know. Under projects. And there should be two folders. One is for pictures, and the other one is for badges. If you ever want an image of a badge, like a JPEG image, it's in there. There's a couple good ones. See, we have a standard south end call, four cars on one call.
Go ahead.
You mean with no suspects around or people to talk to?
I mean, when they say code four, I guess that means there's four people on a call.
That's funny.
There was four of them down at Walmart again. Like 15 minutes after they gave a code four. It's like, I'm not going to second guess. I'm not going to. When'd you run that?
C-103?
Yeah, I think so. Sorry, dude. I tried to back up, but I backed up upwind. If she's going to wait right here, since she's releasing the vehicle, that means we don't have to impound it because it's the wrong way on a one-way street. Now, it's kind of a tricky maneuver here to get you over to the Chase parking lot. There is a parking lot right there, but the Chase parking lot is probably the best well-lit parking lot in the area. So what we'll have to do is have you turn around the vehicle and make a turn and go right into the Chase parking lot. Just to let you know, it's a DV.
Oh,
No bail warrant.
I was actually there when that happened.
Okay,
and
there's
In
situations like that, we have no option. We must arrest.
I understand.
That warrant has nothing to do with what happened here tonight.
No, I know.
Two solely separate incidents. But what happened here tonight, based off what you're telling us, what she told us, and what they told us, both sides, is going to be put together in a report, and it's going to be referred to the prosecutor's office, because I wasn't here. I wish I could have been a fly on the wall and seen everything that occurred. What's that?
I mean, he assaulted her.
Okay.
That's obvious. She's bleeding.
Right. And he doesn't deny the fact that he punched her.
Okay.
He does not deny that fact.
Okay.
So that's not in dispute. It's just we have two separate sides of what happened.
I'm sure there are differences.
And, you know, sometimes we can't determine what happened because we weren't here. We did not witness it with our own eyes.
Sure.
And situations like that, those are situations that sometimes get referred to the prosecutor's office to make a decision on filings of charges.
Sure.
Okay. That's kind of where we are today.
I guess
now
my
you need,
point is,
oh, yes, you
no, I guess my only thing is that I get that. Like,
mm-hmm.
obviously, we're not going to, like, give him a sentence tonight or anything.
Right.
But do you at least get taken in when you assault somebody and then figure it
no,
out?
No, not necessarily. Assault in and of itself is not a mandatory arrest crime.
Really?
There are hardly any mandatory arrest crimes. The only mandatory arrest crimes is when there's assault for, or an assault, domestic violence relationship, the warrant. We're in some question right now on is this a domestic relationship or is this not a domestic relationship?
My God,
well, you,
yeah,
again,
no,
you're saying.
I wish you were an FBI. We can pull phone records.
You're saying.
Yeah.
There is. They're saying there's not.
We just paid for our dinner.
Well, we don't have that ability.
Yeah.
Well, just paying for a dinner doesn't necessarily a domestic relationship. There are coworkers that have dinner after having dinner with a coworker after business hours is not necessarily a dating relationship. Again, a fly on the wall could probably tell it. I'm not a fly on a wall, and I can't determine that at this time.
It's really frustrating, though. You know, it's like I was actually the witness. I'm a credible witness.
Okay.
I
and that's your information will be included with the case, and the prosecutors will look at your information, and if it were to go to trial, you will be a witness to what occurred. So
sure.
You'll have all that information.
Okay.
Do you have the keys to the vehicle?
I do, but I have a ticket.
We're going to temporarily allow you just to go to the Chase parking lot.
But you guys, I'm from Kirkland. I'm like just got off work, and I'm.
You want a
my
taxi?
My husband will kill me now
okay.
that I'm like 4 hours late.
Okay.
Yeah,
I know
you
your name.
Call me a cab,
where do you need to go?
I need to go to Kirkland.
Okay, and
I normally use.
Are you
going to
pay with cash or credit card?
Credit card.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's not a problem.
Okay.
So why don't we go ahead? If you want to. Go
Should
to
I go ahead and pull over here and walk back over
yeah.
here?
Yeah, pull it over. So
are
you have... That's what I was going to look at. Yeah, keys are still in it.
Oh, okay.
So you should be able to... Now, this is a one-way street, so we got vehicles right here. So what you need to do is you need to back around this corner very carefully. Once you're there, come over here. You can see the intersection. It's kind of a tricky intersection. When you get a green light, you can kind of make a slight left turn into the lanes over there.
Okay. And
which
go
are the ones
into the parking lot
and go into the parking
the
lot
ATM?
Where by the ATM. I'd park it right in directly into that light pole where it's well lit.
Okay.
Make sure you lock all the doors. Take the keys with you so the door so it's secure. If you want to wait inside the vehicle for the taxi cab.
Well, are you guys leaving?
Well, we're not leaving right away. We want to make sure you get it over there.
Okay.
Okay. So I'll stay right here to make sure it's clear so you can back around this corner, all right? Okay, ma'am, you got a green light, so go ahead and take it. Was the taxi going to meet her at the Chase parking lot?
Here.
Well, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And 21, if I didn't advise, got one custody on that Valley Con.
W1, custody, 2341.
That would hurt. That would hurt.
That's a healthy glass, yeah.
Yeah.
He said in his statement he thought it was a bottle.
Well, look how thick it is.
Yeah.
I mean, that'll take out somebody's tire.
You just got me a sub.
Oh, no, definitely. No, that's cool. That's fine.
Keep cussing.
Everybody does it. No, as soon as I get done with this, I'll replay it.
Okay.
Just so so I can get the specifics down, because,
awesome.
You know, from what I saw, they were already outside the vehicle. They were chasing him down.
Okay.
He was trying to get away from
them. That's what he said. He was walking towards the door. She got out of the vehicle and was coming at him. You pulled up and told him, you guys need to separate. See, he's got the most consistent...
He has the most consistent, incredible story.
Incredible story.
And I don't see somebody issuing a no bail warrant when someone is, yeah.
Well, you heard what she said, that her husband, this is from when her husband beat her up.
Right.
She left, so who knows what he claimed.
I mean, that could have been, she never got her.
Different address and, so.
Yeah, I guess that's very.
Do you mind if I take off with her to get her down to Kent?
No, that's
okay,
fine, that's fine.
He's asking if we hang
okay,
Kent.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
All right.
Did they say who was en route? Yet?
No, I haven't heard that.
It's been busy, so.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you. No, not talking to you. Ma'am? Do you want to wait right by the corner or under
where
here under the light?
Where did you call the cab for?
The cab's going to come right here to 2nd and Burnett.
Okay. You're
so
going to wait here?
I can wait for you if you'd like.
Okay, good. Because, like,
I mean,
don't
if you want, you can have a seat in the back of my vehicle.
I don't know who these people are that we
okay.
just came to visit. I don't know if they're going to come out and retaliate. I don't know what's going on.
No. If you just want to.
So did they not arrest him?
What's that? He was not arrested.
Oh, man. You got to be kidding. How does that work?
It works just like it worked here tonight. Taxi will be here in about 5 to 10 minutes if you want to wait over here.
So where are they taking her? Where can I go get her at?
She the warrant that she has is a no bail warrant, so she cannot post bail.
Tonight?
Tonight, correct. She has to see a judge. So she will see a judge probably sometime tomorrow, and then the judge will determine whether there's to be bail issued. Judge determines whatever they want to determine.
So,
she could be released, or a
bail
could be set.
Right.
It could be cash only, or it could be bondable. I don't know. It would be up to the judge. She's going to the city of Kent jail, which is just south of her, south of here. They have their own jail facility.
If I gave her phone, would she not be able to use it?
It would go with her, but she wouldn't be able to use it. It would be kept with her.
Ask her if she wants it.
Yeah, I can ask her.
Like,
you gotta ask her real quick. I'm gonna ask her a question real quick.
Okay.
If she wants her phone or not.
Busy yelling at me, so.
Okay. Ma'am, there? Would you like your phone to go with you?
Yeah.
Your cellular telephone? Okay.
Thank
okay. You. I'll give it to the officer, and the officer will make sure it gets handed over to the Kent officers.
Well.
And I think it just shuts off with that button.
Yeah. Kiss, do you want me to keep your phone? Kiss.
Is your friend to keep your phone, or do you want it? She wants her phone.
Okay. Here it is. Okay. We'll go back over here, ma'am. Don't want to stand here by the entry. It'll be kind of dangerous. It'll be a Far West taxi, ma'am. Should be here within about 5 to 10 minutes.
Not to be cheap or anything, but did they say how much that costs?
You know, I have no idea. I've never. Never. You know, as far as we could take you would be the northern city limit of Renton, and that would get you nowhere near Kirkland.
Mm-hmm. You know, it's a trip though. Is that my brother actually was drunk downtown Seattle a couple years ago, and Seattle cops drove him all the way back to Kirkland.
You know, Seattle to Kirkland, north end of Seattle to Kirkland is a lot
downtown Seattle, yeah.
A lot closer than Renton to Kirkland. Sometimes we'll go outside of the city limits for a courtesy transport, but not all the time. Just it all depends on the situation. And in fact, that might be your taxi right there. Yeah, I believe this is your taxi. Going to Kirkland? Yeah, I think that's your fare right there.